It's hard to imagine space without the International Space Station. The massive castle in the sky has modules from Russia, the US, Europe, and Japan. The Japanese Experiment Module, more affectionately known as Kibo, is the largest module of the ISS by far. As it's also the quietest part of the station, it's a popular backdrop for interviews. I'm sure you've seen it before. It's been around since around 2008, but concepts for Kibo go way back to 1985, when Japan got involved with Space Station Freedom, the project that would eventually turn into the International Space Station. The design didn't change much since then, and so, 23 years later, Kibo was launched aboard STS-123, 124, and 127 to the ISS. At the time, the ISS wasn't expected to last beyond 2013, as the lifespan of the oldest modules aboard the ISS was only about 15 years. Now, Kibo was supposed to last at least 10 years, as such, it would be around for at least 5 years after the end of the ISS project. And so, there were ideas floating around to have Kibo as the basis for a new space station, the JSS. Around 2008, JAXA employees were tasked with developing ideas to make use of the modular design of the HDV, JAXA's brand new cargo spacecraft for resupplying the ISS, to be launched from Japanese soil roughly every year starting in 2009. The propulsion module for the HDV didn't need the rest of the HDV, which would make the design very versatile. One of these ideas was to convert HDVs to space station modules. For example, the pressurized section could be enlarged and fitted with docking ports, and another HDV could be converted into a service module and fitted with large solar arrays. This station could then either recycle Kibo from the ISS or launch a brand new module based on the Japanese experiment module. This Japanese space station would be developed exclusively using Japanese technology, giving JAXA more freedom to use the space station for anything they'd like. Ideas include assembling satellites for lunar or Martian missions, Earth or space observation, and experiments, much like the experiments performed on Kibo now. Sadly, none of the ideas for the HDV went anywhere. This wasn't the only quote-unquote Japanese space station proposed around this time. In 2006, the Japanese space law was conjured into existence. According to this law, the Japanese government was to provide a basic plan for space policy every 5 years, the first of which was to be delivered in 2009. The reasoning was that Japanese spaceflight was too expensive and too focused on R&D. In the wake of this law, the think tank Chūnokai was founded. They considered the ISS too big for what it needs to do, and thus proposed the Joint Space Station. The idea was to remove the US orbital segment from the ISS, and to turn this into a new space station after removing some modules. This space station would then make use of an adapted HDV as a service module, and would be far smaller than the ISS, but also not nearly as expensive to operate and maintain. They weren't the only ones with ideas to make use of space station parts to make a new space station after the ISS project ended. Russia had similar ideas with OPSEC. The idea was to decouple the Russian orbital segment and convert that into a new space station. Instead, the ISS project got extended. The ISS modules are now far too old to be incorporated into a new space station. And as such, Roscosmos has revisited the idea, and instead intends to make a new space station based on the Russian orbital segment over the next few years. ROS. Just like Russia, Japan never ended up going through with the reuse of Kibo for a new space station. When 2009 rolled around, the basic plan didn't mention any new ambitions for human spaceflight. Resources were instead poured into more directly useful stuff, such as QZSS, a GPS system specifically for use in the Japanese urban jungle. Nevertheless, I do like to think about what could have been. I also think Japanese space tech doesn't get nearly the attention it deserves, so I do hope to make more videos like this in the future. Until then, I'll see you next time. Bye!